Hallo Leute! First of all, I have to apologize to you, because in the last lesson, lesson 3, I have mentioned the continents. And I forgot one small continent. Well, to be honest, it wasn't that small, because it was Asia. How could I forget Asia? Well, so I assume it got lost in the editing, but of course I don't want to forget 4.5 billion people, so that's why I will quickly name all the continents again before we start with today's lesson. The continents are Europa, Europa, Africa, Africa, Amerika or Nordamerika und Südamerika, Antarktis. Ozeanien or Australien and Asien. Asien. Thank you. Thank you everyone. Thanks. But let's move on. Willkommen zu einem neuen Video. Ich heiße Steffi and this is the free German course for beginners. Check out the description below to download the PDF for free. You will find there the whole vocabulary of today's lesson. After this lesson, you will be able to say I live in German. I roughly mentioned it in the last video, but let's have a closer look at it today. The question is, where do you live? In German we ask, wo wohnst du? This is informal. Wo wohnst du? And in formal we would ask, wo wohnen Sie? Wo wohnen Sie? Wo means where in German. Wohnst or wohnen are our conjugated verbs. And du is you in informal German and sie is also you, but in formal German. And your answer is, and it doesn't matter if you talk now in formal or informal, it's always the same, you would say, ich wohne in. Ich wohne in. And then you add the place, the continent, the country or the city. I already mentioned Berlin, Hamburg and München in the last video. Now I will give you some more German cities. Frankfurt, Frankfurt. Stuttgart, Stuttgart. Köln, Köln. And the last city, Dresden, Dresden. By the way, that's a place you have to go if you are looking for a nice Christmas market in Germany. And now it's your turn. Write in the comments, in which city do you live? Write, ich wohne in, and then at the city. We can also be a bit more specific and mention for how long we already live at some place. For how many days, for how many weeks, for how many months, or for how many years. The day is der Tag in German. Der Tag. And in plural, die Tage. A week is die Woche. Die Woche. And in plural, die Wochen. Die Wochen. Der Monat means month in German. Der Monat. And in plural, die Monate. Die Monate. Das Jahr means year. Das Jahr. And in plural, die Jahre. Die Jahre. Let's look at some example sentences. Ich wohne seit 3 Jahren in Deutschland. Ich wohne seit 3 Jahren in Deutschland. I live in Germany for 3 years. Ich wohne seit 20 Tagen in Berlin. Ich wohne seit 20 Tagen in Berlin. Or for example, ich wohne seit 2 Wochen in Hamburg. Ich wohne seit 2 Wochen in Hamburg. And the last example is, ich wohne seit 1 Monat in München. Ich wohne seit 1 Monat in München. Okay, let's look at all these sentences together and see if we can find some similarities. Okay, I can tell that all these sentences use the preposition seit. And we have to use seit. You cannot use für, because for in German means für. But, and this is very important, you can't always use the same prepositions in other languages. Sometimes it works, but sometimes it doesn't. So very important, here we have to use seit. The second thing you might have noticed here is that the endings are changing. So we do not say seit 3 Jahre, we have to say seit 3 Jahren. Or for example, we do not say seit 1 Monat, we say seit 1 Monat. And the reason for it is der Dativ. Ja, der Dativ. In English, Dative. This is one of the 4 cases in German. We will talk about it much more in future videos. For now, just remember, seit always needs Dative. Seit plus Dativ. Well done! And now, I have prepared a little homework for you. Hausaufgabe! By now, you should be able to say your name, where are you from, and also, where do you live in German? So here is task number 1. Please answer the following questions in the comments. Wie heißt du? Your answer should be ich heiße pam 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 pam. Add your name. Das ist ein schöner Name. This is a beautiful name. Next question. Woher kommst du? Woher kommst du? Your answer should be ich komme aus. You have to use the preposition aus here. Wow, interessant. Wow, interesting. And the third question is, wo wohnst du? Wo wohnst du? You have to answer with, ich wohne in. Ich wohne in. And then you add the country, the city, or maybe the village that you are living in. But that's not it for today. Stay with me. I have a second task for you. Let's practice the pronunciation. Die Aussprache. Aussprache. I can't check you right now because I can't hear you, but I recommend you to do the task anyways and check yourself. You can also record yourself and then listen to me and then to your recording and then compare if these are similar. So, listen to me what I say very carefully and then repeat after me. I will say everything 2 times. First, I will say it in normal speed, and then second, I will say it in slow motion. So let's do it. Repeat after me. Wie heißt du? Wie heißt du? The second one is Wie heißen Sie? Wie heißen Sie? Nice. The next one is Ich heiße. Ich heiße. Your turn. Well done. The next one is Mein Name ist. Mein Name ist. Excellent! The next one is Ich komme aus. Ich komme aus. Fantastic! And the last one for today is ich wohne in. Ich wohne in. Your turn. Well done, guys! Gut gemacht, Leute! This was lesson 3 of the free German course for beginners. How to say I live in German. And you made it! Congratulations! Don't forget to download the PDF in the description. It's completely free for you to download. Every Monday I upload a new lesson. So don't forget to subscribe and activate the bell so you don't miss any future lessons. And it's not too late to start the free German course for beginners. You can watch lesson 1 here. Start the course from the beginning. You will find many more videos on my channel, Lerne Deutsch. Macht's gut, Leute. Bis dann. Tschüss.